Slicers are one of my favorite features in Power BI. They make your reports interactive and dynamic. Today, we're going to deep dive into how you can make the most out of slicers for your reports. Hi, my name is Anne from Adair-Major Consulting, and I've been adding slicers to Power BI reports for 8 years. Today, we're going to really look at what are the different types of slicers that are available and what's the best way to make the best use out of them for your reports. And to do that, first things first, a common point of confusion when starting out is the difference between filters and slicers. Think of it like this. Filters are rules. You, as a report designer, set those behind the scenes. They're quite rigid and they apply to everyone. They can be changed by the report viewer, but it's not quite as easy, nor is it on the main canvas. So, for example, in this employee dashboard, what if I only wanted to show the data for corporate services? So I can drag in division, and that filter is now applied. And I can even lock it so nobody can change it. I've essentially set a rule. But that's not very interactive, and it doesn't invite people to explore. That's where slicers come in. A slicer is an interactive tool that you put right in the canvas for your report users. So let's look at a slicer. I grab a slicer visual and I add the same division field. I can see now it's really easy to click and change it between sales and marketing or corporate services. And I watch the whole report change in front of my eyes. It's not a rule you're forcing your user into. It's a choice the user gets to make. We're giving them the power to explore, which is so much more engaging than a filter. So now you're on board with slicers. You're going to need to know which one to use and when. So we're going to cover the essentials. The classic is a list slicer. It's perfect for fields with just a handful of options, like our division slicer. But what happens if we want to filter by job role? That's much longer. And that's where something like the dropdown comes in handy. To swap from the classic list to a dropdown, I just select the slicer and in the format settings, find slicer settings and switch the style from list to dropdown. Instantly, that list collapses into one clean little bar. This is a real game changer for saving space and giving your users an interactive feel. Pro tip for you here is that if it's a really long list, you can even add a search function. We're going to look at that in a little bit. When you're working with text for your slicers, another handy tip is using a hierarchy. So we've got division and department. So we could add two slicers. But what's really slick is having a hierarchy. A hierarchy is way cleaner. And all we have to do is just drag department field into the same slicer under division. You've got this lovely, neat, nested list. Then users can expand or collapse the list within the slicer. Be mindful that with a really complex data set, this could have some performance issues. But with most reports, just a really fantastic way to keep things tidy. I mentioned a search bar, so this is a good example. If I have a really long list, like for example, names, I can click the three dots above and all I have to do is click search. This is going to add the search function into my dropdown list. So here you can see I can search for Anne and I don't see any entries. But if I search for Kevin, I can see a result. That lets me find the exact entry I'm looking for really quickly without any scrolling. However, now that we've selected that, it's not super intuitive to be able to select the rest again. So as a report designer, you can add a select all option in. If we go into the slicer settings, again into selection, choose to add a select all option. And there we go. Almost all users want to be able to filter by dates and numbers, and Power BI has some seriously powerful tools to do this. Let's start by adding a slicer for the hire date. By default, you'll get this between slider. It's perfect for letting a user grab specific date range. It's really interactive. We could also add a dropdown here. That can be a lot with dates, but a handy tip is to be able to add the date and then update the format to just a month and year in the format pane. This is a great way to aggregate those dates and still gives your users the ability to pick and choose. If I want to select more than one, I hold down Control on my keyboard. Then I can just click the ones I want to select. However, If that's not something that you think your users will know to do, you can change it. So again, in the selection setting, I can change the multi-select with control off. And now, just when I click more than one, it will select. There's another option for dates that I absolutely love, and I use this all the time to keep my reports relevant and feeling up to date. In the slicer settings, you can change your style to relative date. This lets users filter with dynamic language, like the last 10 years, or even the next 3 months, if that's relevant for your data set. Your report now stays up to date automatically, depending on the day that the user is using it, without having to manually punch in a new date range each and every single month. The slicer options and settings that we use for dates are really similar for numbers, and that's another way of it coming in handy. For example, here I've used it with the salary. The button slicer was recently enough improved in Power BI, and in fact, it might still be in preview, so check that you've got that enabled. We're going to use it here for our active and inactive employees. The greatest thing about the button slicer is the amount of customization we can do to its look and feel. So I'm going to add the slicer and then drop the status field in. Right away, it looks okay, but the magic sits in the formatting pane. For active and inactive, I'm going to change it to selected icon. We can also do things like remove the borders or change the background colors or change the color of the icon. We also, on top of that, can change the different colors or formatting depending on the different state. So what does it look like when it's clicked versus when it's hovered versus when it's not clicked? The amount of customization is amazing, but it actually can get a little bit confusing trying to remember what you control where. So whether that be the background color or the text color, which sits under callout values. Something I suggest is using the search function within the formatting pane. That lets you type callout values, for example, and find that setting straight away. By the way, if you're getting a lot out of these tips and you're ready to level up your Power BI skills, make sure that you hit the subscribe button. I share new tutorials every week to help you build better reports using the experience I have with my own clients. Ready for a couple more pro moves that'll help your report feel really polished? Well, what about edit interactions? So in this example, I've got a visualization to my left of my report, which I don't want to change when I make other selections. So if we use the active status slicer as an example, all I need to do is select that slicer and then go to the format tab in the ribbon and click edit interactions. Interactions are how one visualization changes or doesn't change another visualization. You'll see when I have my slicer selected that the other visualizations have little icons above them. So in this case, while I have my slicer selected, I look at the visualization I don't want to change and I click the little circle. When I do that, it'll become filled in. This means it will not interact. There will not be any changes to this visualization based on changes made in that slicer. The next tip I have for you is about syncing slicers. And this is all about making your reports efficient for your end user's experience. So have you ever had a situation where you choose filters on one page, and then you go to another page and you have to choose all those filters again? So with syncing slicers, is I can have slicers on my first page, make selections within those slicers, and then they will sync onto another page when I click onto it. So let's say I have my employee summary page and my employee details page. Well, all I do is copy the slicer from one, paste it onto the next, and Power BI will ask me straight away, do I want to sync these? Now, when I make a selection on my second page, it will apply to my first and vice versa. You can manage all of this in Sync Slicers, which you find under the View tab. That lets you decide exactly which pages it shows up and which pages it syncs on. You can even have a slicer be synced but hidden on a page, so it filters the data without it taking up any space. Finally, let's talk about key consideration for any report builder: performance. Slicers are fantastic for the user, And to keep them that way, I've got four rules. Use filters for rules. If you need a filter to be permanently on and you don't want it to change frequently, or in fact, you maybe don't want anyone to be able to change it at all, use the filter pane. Next, use slicers for exploration. Give slicers to your users for things they should be able to play with and explore the data on their own. Take advantage of the real power of Power BI, being able to slice and dice data and curate the user's experience. Rule 3, be intentional. A page with 10 slicers can be just as confusing as a page with none. So be intentional. What are the most important ways your users will want to cut the data? Give them those, but don't go overboard. And my fourth and final rule for slicers is handle high cardinality fields with care. This is a big one. Be super careful about what fields you're putting a slicer on. So a slicer on a field with millions of unique values, like a transaction ID, well, that can really slow your report down to a crawl. If you've enjoyed the guide today, then you might find others valuable. I'm going to leave a link just here which shows you 5 good habits to adopt for any report that you're building. They save me time and time again. I really do suggest checking it out. Just here. I'm just going to leave it right here. How easy is that? I've left it just here. Probably over here.